the Slender Man, a tall, thin, faceless humanoid creature who is known for stalking, abducting, or killing people, primarily children. A being that may be with us longer than we care to know. After years of researching the Slender Man phenomenon, people from all over the world have contacted me with their first-hand accounts of witnessing or coming into contact with this being. One of the most compelling stories was from a man in the United States. Not alone had he come into contact with the entity, he had a fascinating theory as to what the Slender Man might be. I decided to travel there to meet John Smith for myself and examine this case. He had asked me to meet him at a remote location in Vermont County.
Hello?
Get in.
Yeah.
Give us it.
What?
Give me it.
Why?
You can't record till I've decided you're okay.
At this point, we drove for hours into a remote, wooded wilderness, where he eventually allowed me to turn the camera back on.
Yeah. Right. Now that you've let me record again, can you tell me what you were telling me in the car?
Which bit? All of it?
Well, yeah. Your theory on the Slender Man, what it is.
We break down Slender Men by what they are, and they have to be a cephalopod. They have tentacles.
Wait, well. That's a squid.
Yeah, squiddy thing. You asked me that before. Was that just for the fucking camera?
Well, I'm still trying to understand why you think the Slender Man is.
They have tentacles. They imitate people, but they're probably just imitate. Cephalopods can imitate stuff in general. They have remarkable control over their skin textures. I mean, that's the only thing that fits the bill. I mean, they obviously secrete some sort of thing when threatened. Something that makes people highly afraid of everything. I mean, that's just a neurotoxin. I mean, is that a huge jump from venom secreted by other creatures?
You're saying that the Slender Men or Slender Beings are some sort of cephalopod that the...
Yeah, squid.
The effects that we see from Slender Men of paranoia and things of that sort are caused by a neurotoxin that they secrete.
And I mean, we don't know what it is. We won't know.
But how did we make a leap from cephalopod to this creature that's being seen now?
This is the only creature that has tentacles. It's highly intelligent, able to mimic people. See, that's the thing. You can't mimic people perfectly.
So you're saying this is a biological entity of this earth?
Yeah, it's the thing we can shoot. I mean. And that's the thing, once we shoot one, that will be it. We're 100 miles away from the nearest house, and in that house, 7 days ago, a child went missing.
Right.
Police, when they're looking to do missing children thing, they go for the obvious targets. They call relatives, they monitor bus stations and stuff. These people's house backed on to this remote wilderness.
Yeah.
This remote wilderness just goes on forever behind their fucking house. I mean, but the police won't. I mean, they did some preliminary searches, but they're not gonna. If this thing is like a cephalopod that's able to travel through trees and stuff, it's not gonna leave man tracks.
No.
And that's what they're gonna be looking for.
What do you...
You see them?
Yeah. Yeah. What are they doing out here? What?
They're clean. These are clean and dry.
Yeah.
We're 100 miles away from the nearest house, and these things are clean and dry.
What? What does that mean?
I don't know. Maybe it was trying to make the place more homely for the kid it took.
Homely.
You know.
What are you doing? What are you doing?
I'm putting on a mask.
Why are you putting on a mask?
The neurotoxin, remember?
Oh gosh. Do I get a mask?
Did you bring a mask?
Oh gosh.
Try to be quiet.
What?
Get the light fucking down. Kill it.
Yeah. Where's he gone?
After I heard the gunshots, he never came back. I was alone. I searched the woods and found what was left of him. I found my way back to the car, and then I saw it. That was 2 weeks ago now. I haven't gone anywhere near that place again. I've tried to contact John Smith, but I can't. I have to assume at this point something happened to him, and it was as a result of the Slender Man. If indeed his theories are correct, the creature may have killed him to protect its own environment. The local police there have now listed him as missing.